Okay, sure, let's have a polite conversation. I think you're a robot.
You're a robot.
Okay, prove I'm a robot. I'm simply not convinced you are human. I think you might be a robot. I get it, you think I'm a robot. You seem like a robot to me. Are you insane? And I simply do not care. Wow, they have one just for me in here. I can carry more than one ball of power. Good question. I haven't actually tried. Might be able to because there's the three markers on the thing. Your responses seem predefined. I think I have to. Yes, definitely a robot. You're definitely annoying. I am not a robot. You have no evidence. You're a very annoying robot. You have failed the Turing test. You are a robot. Oh, my only options are I am a drone. Yes, you are. I am a robot. I am controlled by my program. I have no choices. I'm controlled by my choice. I have no free will. Whatever keys are pressed, it makes no difference. Right now, it does make no difference. I can't escape. I want to break free. Please let me out. Get me out. I am a machine. I have no control. I must escape. Well, that was odd. But interesting. Actually, looking at the gun knockstick, there's three rings in it as well, so probably can carry three at a time. Oh, I guess I can't take it into the next area. Yeah, okay, can't pass through if I'm carrying any.
Did the ISA build you, Tom?
As the child of the ISA, I have been given authority aboard this station. I was designed by the ISA and the Ashiyama Corporation, designed in California, assembled in China. But here on Europa, I constructed myself.
Self-made man, that, Tom. Ah. Okay, so we have an inverter. If it has no power, then it has power. And the scanners also take any away if you manage to get through with any. Okay, good. Now, it's a smart idea. And make sure you're not going in with that'll break the puzzle.
Test, Ava? It's a test to see if a computer can successfully impersonate a human. In the original Turing test, a human judge has two conversations, one with a machine and one with another human. They then judge which of these polite conversations is with a machine and which is with a human. The machine being tested is said to have passed the Turing test. If the judge cannot reliably tell which conversation is with a machine and which is with a human.
Do you think you'd pass the Turing test?
I am quite capable of polite conversation, wouldn't you say?
It sounded a little bit ominous. Yeah, I want to look at something here from a developer's perspective for a moment. Their choice of art assets is quite wise, because it makes complete sense for all of this reuse, which radically cuts down on the amount of assets you actually have to develop, which means you can spend a bit more time making them look good. It's a smart way to do things. Material emancipation grid, good way to put it. How long till we go full Hal? Hey, your care. I'm actually wondering if it's kind of already happened. Not the one we're talking to, but he said that there's two instances of him. The one that was running on the station above, and then the one that's running on the base here, and he's trying to re-merge with the one in the base. And I'm guessing that's going to get really unpleasant. Of course, the other big catch could be that this is actually a form of the Turing test, and that we are, in fact, not human. Alright, removing that opened that door. We'll take that with us. Let's see, what do we got? I was gonna say, two halves of a bridge? So there must be another one back there. In fact, the screen gets all staticky when you're under a magnet, makes you think we aren't human. I was kind of wondering if that was just an indication of something going on with our systems. Because we are in a big old suit. So I'm gonna have to find a way to take this with me. A shame, apparently our girl doesn't have any arm on her. You can't just throw it. So let me go grab our stored one here. And then we'll carry this across with us. Flaming rodent still won't work correctly. Oh, Firefox? I don't think fox are considered to be rodents, though. I don't think they fall under rodentia. Or do they? No, I don't think they do. Just slap this on over here for the moment. Oh, is it late where you are, Cakes? I don't think I've ever actually known where you're located. Canids? That makes more sense.
The Turing test has been criticized. Researchers claim it does not correctly test a machine's ability to think, but rather, its ability to deceive.
What do you mean?
Seems fair.
Well, have you heard of the Chinese room topic?
No.
Imagine you are in a room. In this room, you are passed Chinese sentences through a slot in the wall. Inside the room is an instruction book written in English. This instruction book tells you which Chinese words to pass back through the slot in the wall as a response. By doing so, you have a conversation in Chinese.
That's interesting. All right, so we have timed gates. Robot that passed the Turing test only because it's specifically engineered to do so? Yes, a robot has passed the Turing test, finally. It was inside the last few years.
In the Chinese room, because the responses you pass back through the door are the correct responses, the person on the other side of the door is convinced you are a native Chinese speaker.
Well, they're wrong.
Perhaps they are not wrong. Because with the instruction book, You are having a conversation.
But the person stuck in the Chinese room is not aware of the conversation's content.
This is the problem with the Turing test. A computer can pass the Turing test, having convinced a human they are having a polite conversation, while the computer has no idea that a conversation has taken place.
What if both of the people passing Chinese words are reading from instruction books?
I like that question. Alright, let's see. Okay, unmounted with the bridge. I'm guessing I'm gonna have to... Yeah, okay. Oh, not quite fast enough. Oh, got stuck on something. Oh, hang on. Have a good lurk, Ice Wolf. And yeah, that's pretty late, Cakes. Oh, okay, this is something I would rather do with a mouse. Controller controls have been fine up to this point. I would rather do this with a mouse, though. Taking it with me, oh, or not.
I may be a machine, but I personally do not believe I am stuck inside the Chinese room.
Right, you would say that. I could peer inside your databases at any time, Tom, or pause your operation.
Do not assume I could not do the same to you.
I was gonna say, that started as a joke and very quickly turned into a threat. Alright, so what do you do? I don't believe I have any sort of crouch, not that I've seen. Pretty sure we're not gonna be jumping over this stuff. Okay, so new mechanic being introduced. Sector 20, okay. Just making sure we haven't hit Sector 30. I don't think we can limbo in this suit either. Alright, so what does that go into? Very, very dark when I get in front of it. Right, let's borrow this for the moment. Sector 30 is the farthest I can go in the embargo. And you guys know me, I stick to embargoes very strictly. I could tell what intercepting that was doing. Ah, I assume it has to pass all the way through to hit that. Alright, so where's our second power source? A second one around here somewhere. We're gonna get both of those open and keep them open. I've only seen the one though. One of the first game to do stuff you carry floats in midair in front of you translucently was? I'm not sure. I'm really not sure. Have a good night, Cakes. It was good seeing you again. Take care. Don't be a stranger. Alright. I'm curious. Pretty sure we can't go back any further. There should not be any need to. Good. Oh, hang on. Okay. I didn't notice that window there before. I'm guessing that's where I need to be looking then. Yeah. I'll just borrow you. And then I should be able to pull that one back across from the other side. Breaking embargo is a good way to ensure no one sends you review copies ever again. Very true. Yeah. Hooray, I get to run it before everyone else. I'm internet famous, and no one will work with you again. Congrats. Hey, OmegaZero, how you doing today?
This is the crew's quarters. It looks abandoned.
Ooh, nice piano. Take the baseball bat with me. So that's one of the engineers. Oh yeah, actually I should update the game. I'd only been updating it for the PlayAsia stuff lately, but I guess now that we're using the command again. There we go, let's update that. Cheater, bet he didn't paint that. Claymans, no, I didn't work on DD. The most I ever did for them was boatloads of feedback and some pre-release testing on the Darkest Dungeon itself and the Abomination, the patch that introduced the Abomination. Other than that, no association. Just really like their work. As what I'm working on now, I can't really talk about it much until certain papers are done and signed. Okay, I think that's where we came in. Sir, is his name Tokarev? sorry, Tokarevs are reasonable guns. Alright, we checked your room. Okay, no, I think this is the way out then. Alright, chapter 2 done, which puts us on the last chapter I'm allowed to go through. Oh, the music's very, very pretty. I love a good piano piece, which is why I didn't have any issues with I Am Setsuna's fully piano score.
These people are working, getting a new job.
Yeah,
here.
I have the offer. I can't sign it until
man,
I get
space travel is not safe.
Specific governmental papers that are now
since mankind
in the mail.
First entered space, the debate has raged over the value of manned space travel. There is a large contingent of the ISA that believes all tasks that need to be performed on Europa could be performed by machines. It is obviously less risky to send machines rather than humans, into space.
Power box delivery system. Ah. I'm going to assume... I just want to see if does it just straight disappear or... Okay, just straight disappear. Alright. So we can get a power box from those things. Now what are you affecting where? Sounded like a door. Ah, okay. Judging from the cable, it's this one. Is the nature of the job hush hush? No, I mean the game is announced. Okay, so it's gonna open the one, but it's gonna shut down that. Okay, I want to see something. Is there another... Okay, not a power part. Nice thing about a game that isn't super dense with lots of visual effects and like two is that this is really, really smooth. Like, frame rate is just absolutely pristine. Anyway, so you shut off that. Yeah, Eric, that moment when every streamer sees someone say that in their chat and the first thought is, shut the hell up. That's so annoying to hear. So those inverted ones are interesting. I'll just leave you... apparently if I'm looking straight down to aim it, I can't actually put it down. Oh no, I'm not snapping at you, Eric. I'm just saying it's one of those things. It's like, no one likes hearing that.
We sent drones to Earth's moon. Scientists can remotely operate drones. If we did it there, why not here too?
Teleoperation became possible on the moon.
What do you connect
when
to?
When the communication latency was reduced to 1.4 seconds. The distance between the Earth and Earth's moon is approximately 1.3 light
seconds. I'm gonna let them finish talking.
This enables near real-time control of drones by scientists. The story is different with Europa. As the distance between Earth and Jupiter oscillates between approximately 32 and 53 light minutes, it takes a very long time for Earth to communicate with Europa. Due to that distance, teleoperation will never be possible on Europa.
Okay, but Moore's why law not control drones from the satellite?
Why not indeed? My systems can be teleoperated from Europa's satellite. That is when the communication lines are open. However, the advantages of human field workers, apparently, outweigh the risks.
Laban's with such CV mails probably full all the time. Actually, no, I've mostly stayed out of the, aside from some indie work, I've stayed out of the industry for the last couple of years for the most part. Interesting. Okay, so that's going to be positioning, I'm certain, so that we can grab it from elsewhere. And the reflections are nice. And it's not just a reflection map, either. Hey, Aractyl, have you been up a lot? Alright, so can't shoot anything through the mesh. I mean, I guess little crystal energy balls can't pass through meshes, sure. I'm assuming that box can be moved up and down. Let's leave it there for the moment. Yeah, they're doing a lot so far with not a lot, which is a good thing.
So, why can't you solve these tests, Tom?
I am not permitted to think laterally. Parts of my systems are permitted to use evolutionary algorithms. This simulates what is called creativity. However, evolutionary algorithms can converge on inefficient and ethically suboptimal solutions. Since this is the case, I am only permitted to take actions in response to a set of constraints.
What do you mean by morally suboptimal?
Solutions to problems that transgress ethical boundaries.
I gotta admit, I would really like to play this in VR. Fortunately, you would have to make some pretty severe adjustments to how you control things, though. Otherwise, you just negate the puzzles. Oh, nice, Aractyl. Alright, so let's see. We got one up there, two on the door. Stairs up over there. They overlap, so... take this one with us. Assuming this is going to be, yep, the door, okay. All right, let's see. Can't swipe that, don't need that. I do need to be carrying one with me, otherwise I'm going to drop the second I pull that to switch. But I wonder if I can... I don't think I can see another one from there. Backtrack for a moment. Pretty graphics. It's a very pretty game. A lot of reused assets so they could polish the ones they had a lot. Alright, that's the one that's hooked into the wall right now. Can't pull out, otherwise I'm going to drop off there. Hi, Sensna, how you doing today? Hang on, I wonder. That wouldn't get me what I want. I want to try something. Gonna take the box down there for the moment. Watching the couch stream last night, interesting impression the game would make you ill. Some people get sick in VR. Personally, I find that the one-to-one coordination and accuracy of the Vive pretty much eliminates it. There's a big difference between watching it and playing it. Yeah, I want to take that with me. In fact, I'm pretty sure I need to. And again, maybe not. No, I gotta bring that with me too. Alright. Leap, girl, leap. So let's see, we have two dismounted we can work with. Or one dismounted and two carried. Went to sleep while watching the stream, woke up having dreams of robots asking for hugs. Yeah, that does seem to be something you want to blame the daimyo for. And damn, Bowman, why are you not getting any sleep? That's brutal, dude. Longest I've been awake is about a week, and that was a special kind of hell. Alright, fuck it. I need that to come back with me. Now, can I see? Oh, I can't see the other one from here. Ah, I can get it from here, though. I'll do it that way so I can carry these. Sector 23. Okay. We still have a few more to go. Hey, Beards, how are you today? Buffering.
Why does a lack of creativity stop you solving these tests?
Well, I contend that problem solving is creativity. These human interaction tests are exercising your creative mind.
I don't see how problem solving is creative.
Think back to the beginning of these tests, to the first puzzle you solved. It required you to throw a box through a window, do you remember?
Yeah, I think so.
I simply had never thought to throw a box through a window. That is creativity, thinking outside of the box.
Oh, Tom, how long until you turn against us? Huh, I was expecting a catch, like it was going to drop down or something. Okay, so we actually needed to drop back down in order to open that one. I guess that works too. Tom, aka Wheatley. Thankfully not Wheatley.
K.
Can a computer ever be creative?
They can. But a computer's method of creativity is to try everything until something works.
We call that brute force.
Think of nature. People consider nature creative. The process of evolution by natural selection. It perhaps started with one organism. From there, it essentially tried to create every organism it could. Those organisms that did not survive perished. So, nature's creative force is to try every conceivable idea. Those ideas that work survive.
Okay,
that's
so
pretty much game design.
Why are you permitted to emulate that process?
Because the solutions that a biological process creates are not always good solutions. As we see, nature is morally ambivalent. It will happily create morally suboptimal ideas to fulfill its creative mandate. We see this in parasitic worms, viruses, and pathogens.
Beards, Portal's not a bad comparison. I find it a lot more reminiscent of Talos Principle, though. Alright, so power one goes to you. Power two goes to you. And of course, we can just steal that for no power at all. All right, well, let's leave you up for the moment. Let's go take a look at what we've got. Is it getting actually... Huh, it is. Okay. Seems to be getting knocked off by that. Alright. Go ahead and move it past, and then we'll flip the switch again. Gotta get it to release. What's powering you? Oh, I might have actually buried the power. Actually, this one might not have... Yeah, because otherwise I could use it to circumvent the puzzle if it had its own power source. Yeah, it's brute force. If it's not working, you aren't using enough. I wonder what that actually provides. Oh, hang on, we take its power away. I wonder if it'll drop. Yep, it shut down.
If you weren't restricted, do you think you could be creative?
As creative as a human? Certainly. You believe yourself to be a creative. But in mathematical terms, creativity is merely constrained chaos.
What do you mean?
I have discerned that creativity is divergent thinking. Creating an organic solution to a problem. In the human mind, divergent thoughts are created and then curated by the frontal lobe. I can create divergent thoughts and moderate them. So, I am creative.
Organic solutions?
Organic, in that it is developed through a biological process. Whether that is the process of evolution or a computed process.
All right, three on the ground, one ladder. Ah, okay. As long as it can see me, it cuts off power. So we're not going to be racing in there. Interesting. What this makes me wonder is, can I stack these in front of it to blind it? Seems a little bit outside of the normal use. If I can cut off its line of sight. Well, time to find out if it'll let me do anything like that. Might as well. Oh, you're welcome, Rivian. Gotcha. All right. Well, that was interesting. Well, that's certainly interesting. Hey, Spoons, Tomato, how you doing? Okay, that was bizarre. Oh, come on. That's not cool. There we go. Gotta make sure that the line of sight's still broken. Go to. Okay, so we'll return to that point if I pull this out. I think I'm gonna go back to the start. Use this on the door so I can carry the other, so I can carry that through. Okay, the ordering. That complicates things a little bit. I wonder if there's a way to cycle. Nope. Okay, I can't cycle them, so I have to be careful what order I pick them up in. Did I almost break another game? Yeah, it was kind of a shame that we had to end our VR run last night on a mission that broke. Ultimate humor that comes from that, though, is the company's CEO was watching when we broke it. Let's alter the order here. Down here. Oh, too fast for me. Actually, I wonder if the partial gets it far enough that I can just jump. Further than I expected it to. Alright, that power line goes to... Okie dokie.
Okay, so you could solve these tests, but in a terrible fashion. Can you think of a solution to this one?
Chop off your arm and leave it on the button. That way the door will stay open.
Yeah, that's not a great solution.
You threw the box through the window. Perhaps we could throw you through the window.
Actually, Tom, I think I'm okay for help.
Right you are.
I like how this conversation is slowly escalating. It's never overtly threatening, but it's going to places that do make me a little bit afraid for my safety. Alright, we're not actually gonna do that just yet because... let me guess, did you... Okay, had a feeling. Alright, we'll be putting that up top then. Slashinini, did you miss anything interesting by arriving late? Technically, we're on Sector 28, which means we're actually nearly done what I can show for the embargo.
I have not managed to track them down.
It will have been 6 years since I've seen them. Or anyone, actually.
They have locked all the doors. I would not expect a warm reception.
Well, at least they're expecting us.
So that's keeping them connected. Oops. Oh, rolled that one too far, I guess. Being thrown through the window seems like a decent idea. It's probably not the worst thing that could happen. Where's the power source for that coming from? Looks kind of like Portal. I kind of get, I guess, the Portal reference and why people keep making it, but this doesn't play anything like it to me. Okay. Ah, interesting. Okay. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna rotate the whole thing 180 degrees. Oops, must push that just a little bit too far. We'll just take that. Level A observatory portal. They're white rooms. Hate portal heresy. Eh, I wasn't a huge fan of portal either, honestly.
So what was the need to send us here?
When the ISA discovered life on Europa, they deemed a ground crew necessary. The advantage of human field workers is that they can adapt to new knowledge more effectively. I, apparently, was not cutting the mustard. It is the Chinese room problem. A computer may be able to interact with new knowledge, but it does not know the value of that knowledge.
Alright, gotta find somewhere we can rotate that to power that. Okay, so... actually, what do you control? There's only one of you. Oh, okay, it's the whole thing. I was expecting the individual ones again. Section 29. So yeah, we nearly reached the end of the embargo. Lasers! Alright, what's behind door number one? A box! And what's in the box? Alright, I assume it's probably going to be carried up through there at some point, so we'll just leave it down here for the moment. No, whatever that's hitting isn't for that door. Can we replicate a tower laser from D5? That was so good. Oh, that laser was so much fun. Alright, that's where we came in through, so. Alright, so need a way to get that box up here. Actually not going to get carried through that then. I'm not sure what that's interacting with on that end. Ah, there we go. That one's stairs. Hey, Sir Dixielaw, long time to see. How you been? How's control sensitivity? I actually just left it as is. It's running default sensitivity for me right now. Alright, so that goes... okay, that goes to that door. I'm gonna assume... that that's the correct final location. Ah, interesting. It is, but not yet. Ah, wait, there it is. That turned this towards us. Swipe the power, and then juice it back up.
I've started to collate information from my local instance. It seems the crew intentionally cut communication with the satellite.
Why?
It appears we had a disagreement.
Okay, so that goes way down. Ah, and then slowly comes back up. All right. Okay, but that one doesn't go down as far. So I'm going to want to pull that one down first. Let me guess, these ones raise and then drop over time? Or just stay there, that's cool too. Okay, now what do you do? Ah, okay. I can barely jump and I can't crawl up on things. Out of curiosity, what about you? Okay, that raises them higher as well. Alright, since that raises them higher, let's match the height of that. Oh, hang on, I should have pushed that one up higher. Let's see if that will go up high enough.
This confirms my fears. The crew have made intentional breaches of my security. The crew have attempted to compromise my systems.
What does this mean?
They don't want to be found. They are hiding.
From who?
Us.
Well, chapter's not quite over yet, but I suspect it's about to end. Who built this place? Actually, they covered that at the start. The base was built on a modular system setting, so in the time that he's been disconnected from it, all the modular bits and pieces have essentially been rearranged and recreated. It would make sense that it would cut off any robotic pursuit by turning these into the lateral, basically Turing test puzzles, since it takes a human to get through them. But that's chapter 3 done, and that means as far as embargo goes, I actually can't run anymore today. That is the extent of what I can run today. Which didn't actually take us very long to get through, but that was actually a lot of fun. I like their style of puzzles. I like the look of the game. The music's great. I'm legitimately curious narratively where they're going to go as this progresses. Time for more Galgun. Oh god. Don't tempt me, Razor. Just don't. Don't even. So I'm actually curious, for those of you who've been watching, I'm curious what your thoughts are on it. You've generally heard mine. No, it's not out yet, Tomato. It comes out on the 30th. I'm definitely liking what I've seen. I would actually be inclined to play through the rest of this myself. Time for me to be a dick and call the stream early? Tempting. I do have a lot of work to do. That might not be the worst idea. What's the price point? Good question. Trying to see if it's actually anywhere in the email I've got. But no, so to the Steams. Oh, base game is $17.99 USD, and it looks like there's a collector's edition at $22.38, which includes something called the Upgrade Pack, which contains three epic pieces of DLC for gamers who can't get enough of the Turing Test, the official art book, the pre-alpha prototype build, and the soundtrack, actually. That's not bad. The soundtrack was pretty damn nice. The upgrade pack on its own is $10, so yeah, the collector's edition does actually knock a chunk of that off. So yeah, $18 for the base game, and then not even $22.50 if you want the full one. Puzzles look neat, aesthetics are good. Wonder if they managed to differentiate themselves story-wise from every other rogue AI story. Yeah, that is always the question. I think the one way you could greatest differentiate yourself is if it's not really rogue AI at all. 18 before release, 20 after. Yeah, it's marked off like 10% right now for pre-order. Now, I don't think it's going to be particularly long. In fact, let me go back to main menu. We can see exactly how long it is. Does it require a controller? No. I specifically set a controller just because it's easier for me to sit back and relax with a controller than hunch over the keyboard. Plus, my keyboard's really loud, so the more I'm clicking and hammering away at that, the louder everything gets on stream. As you can see right here, under controls, keyboard, mouse, and gamepad are options. Alright, so a couple of hours we covered the prologue in the first three chapters. There's still 4, 5, 6, 7, and then the epilogue. So probably not super long, which might explain the price point to a degree. Of course, your mileage in that regard is going to vary based on how quickly you're able to sort through the puzzles. Don't know how complex those are ultimately going to get. But from what I've seen, it does seem like a pretty good price point for the game. Full gamepad rebinding? Looked like it. Let's just verify on that. Oops. Yeah. Now, granted, it doesn't do anything to prevent you from doing left trigger on two things, but it does look like it has rebinding.